Hello and welcome to the Computer Lab Vids YouTube channel. So today we are looking at how to connect your Philips Hue light to your Amazon Alexa. So we'll get straight into the video. The first place you need to go is to the Philips Hue site, which is account.meethue.com, as you can see in the top toolbar there. You need to create this account first because Alexa links to the Philips Hue later on. You'll see that in the video. So you need to fill in your details on the Philips site here. I'll put all these links in the description below. Obviously make sure you go to the right site when you're putting your personal details in. So standard stuff for this account: email address, your name, and also a password of your choice. You can use Google if you have a Google account, a Gmail address, just on the right hand side there. You can use that to sign in and create an account. I usually try to create individual accounts for this type of thing, so I am just going to create a new account for the purpose of this video. So email address, name, password, agree to the terms and conditions at the bottom, and your country of origin, and then click on continue. This will then create the account with Philips. What will happen then? It will ask us to verify our email address, as you can see there. So you need to then go to your mail application. If you have that on the machine, then great, just open it up and just verify your email address for the link that Philips sends you to the address that you have registered. So I'll just verify mine off screen. So you won't see me verifying the email address, but if you just click on the link that the Philips has sent you, verify your email address, and then you're good to go. If you do not verify your account, it will not work when you connect Alexa to the Philips Hue light later on. So once you've verified, obviously this will then disappear and you can log into your account. If you click on the link, it takes you into your account within Philips Hue and asks you to put your username and password in just to log back in. So we will just go into the sign out icon in the top right hand corner because I'm doing mine off screen. So I just need to sign back out and sign back in. Now I've verified my email address with Philips. So again, put in my account, my email address that I registered before, put in the password, and then just click sign in. These are my account details now that are registered to this Philips Hue account. Click on save, and then on the top bar you can see here we have bridge and apps. Now again, this is another important feature that you need to enable. You can see I don't have any bridges added at the moment, so I need to add a bridge. Now, it goes without saying that you should have your Philips bridge connected already in your house, connected directly to your router via the Cat5 cable. So plug direct into the router, and now we need to link our account to the bridge at our address. So find your Philips Hue bridge, you can see here, and there's a button on the top. Push it, click it in, and then just let go. And you can see the on the website there is a timer counting down. If you do not do this within the timer, you'll have to do it again. So once you've pushed the button, by the magic of the internet, it should register that bridge to the account that we have just made. So there we go, the bridge has been recognized and it is successfully linked. You will get then the details of your ID, model number, firmware version, etc. Just blank mine out because they are personal to your actual bridge, your Philips bridge that is configured at your address. And the other thing there, you can actually rename it. So you do have, if you have a couple of bridges that you're setting up, you can put, you know, Philips bridge, Hue bridge in front room or whatever it be. I'm just going to leave mine as it is. And the other thing is you can see there are linked apps. Just checking that nothing's linked in there. There shouldn't be because it's a brand new setup. Okay, so we're good to go with the next stage. So I'll just drag this across onto the left-hand side. So we'll now open my iPhone up. And you can see I've already installed the Amazon Alexa app. This obviously controls anything to do with Alexa and the skills and stuff that are part of the Alexa app. So you need to select the Alexa app, obviously, to go into it. And we need to go into the skills page and link our Philips account to our Amazon Alexa account. So they're both tied together once you access your Alexa. So select the menu icon in the top left-hand corner on your smart device. Mine's an iPhone, so yours might look slightly different. Down to where it says skills, just about two-thirds way down on the list there. You need to select skills. And we are now going to add a new skill to the Amazon Alexa. So I'll just wait for the page to refresh. And then we can do a search for the Philips Hue skill. So box at the top, we need to search for Hue. So just select the box, type in Hue, H-U-E, and then push return, and then it should be the top one. And you can see there, Philips Hue. We need to select the Philips Hue to add that as a skill. Then we need to click on enable, and this will then add this skill to the Amazon Alexa. And now what we're going to need to do, it will now ask for the account details from the Philips Hue. So we need to now put the details in that we have just registered with Philips. So mine was my email address, which I'll just type in there. And then the password is the password that you've just created, again, in the Philips Hue account. And once you put the password in, just click sign in, and then Amazon Alexa will go away and do its magic. And then we should get a request to trust this application, which we do there. Select yes here. Now we need to let Amazon Alexa trust this application to control the Philips Hue lights. So we'll just wait for that to refresh again. Okay, so now it's successfully linked, and we should now get another box where it goes into discovery mode to try and find items that are on our home network and linked to the bridge. Okay, so here we are, discover devices. Smart home devices must be discovered before they can be used with Alexa. So we need to select discover devices. And again, let Alexa go and do its thing. The important thing to note here is make sure that all your lights are already switched on. So if you've got to this stage and not switched your lights on, make sure they are switched on and connected, because otherwise this process will not work. So give it a minute or so just to scan your network, and then you should get a list of all smart devices that Alexa is aware of on your network. So you can see I've got an icon there that has been added, which is all Hue lights, which controls, as it says, all the Hue lights within my household. I have a strip light, and I also have a bulb currently set up. So you can see just on the bottom right, the Hue light strip plus. Now, although it might look like that's all the devices, if you scroll up, you can actually find more devices. So I'll just select the all of the Hue lights at this stage, just to show you there. It's telling you there that light's on and it's set to 100%. But like I say, if you scroll up and down here, you can actually pick different ones. So you can see the different items there that Alexa's aware of. And we need to make sure we pick the right one. So when you select one of these, and it's not already been labeled as a Hue, so I'm going to pick the one that's living room. I know that that's the correct one, but yours might say Hue, Philips Hue, bulb or lamp. So I'm going to click that living room, and I know that this one is the Philips light. And if I click on the edit the color section, the device color, you can then pick these different shades. This is really important because when you ask or request Alexa to change the bulb, you need to say these as the correct term, as they're labeled there. So the other thing we need to do is edit this and give it a name that we recognize and are familiar with. So when we say to Alexa to switch the living room light on, or whatever it is when we put in the name, that is how it will recognize that device. So where we have edit name on the top right hand corner, we need to select edit name and give it a name that you are familiar with and one that you'll remember. I have a living room set as a thermostat, so I don't want to mix the two up. So I'm going to rename mine to front room lamp. So once you give it a name, it should then recognize that, puts that into its database on Alexa. We can now go back and just make sure, we'll just refresh this page and make sure that we have what we have, make sure it is where it should be. So you can see there, there's the light strip, but we want the front room lamp, is what we called it. So we select that one. If you've named yours different, just pick the one that you've named and then make sure that it is the Philips. Okay, so that's the lamp added. So now we can try and make sure it works.
Alexa, turn off the front room lamp.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on the front room lamp.
Okay.
Alexa, Change the colour of the front room lamp to blue.
Okay.
That's how to connect your Amazon Alexa to your Philips Hue lights. So I hope this video has helped. If it has helped, please do subscribe. Please do click on the like button and give us any comments below. And thank you very much for watching the Computer Lab Vids YouTube channel.